You have probably heard so much about personal branding. It's talked about everywhere. You maybe attended some workshops and you've heard people talk about personal branding, and you probably don't know what it is all about, what the fuss is all about personal branding, and maybe you need it, or maybe how can you do it? Well, in most cases, you may have a lot of potential. And everyone knows you can sing, everyone knows you can be a great manager, everyone knows you can be an excellent housekeeper, everyone knows you can do so much. But guess what? The moment they remain a potential inside of you, hidden, those values, they are hidden inside of you, then it's going to be very difficult for you to get people to hire you for the brand that you are. And so this is where personal branding comes to surface. What is personal branding then? Now, personal branding is a way in which you establish and consistently reinforce who you are and the values that you stand for. Okay? As we explore this, I am going to ask you, kindly subscribe to this channel if you have not subscribed before, like the video, and share a comment in response to this, and share with me what are your experiences of branding and maybe any other question you'd want us to answer. Okay, back to personal branding. It is a way in which you consistently reinforce and establish your values. And we do all this to be able to create and establish who we are so that the world can know. The reason why we must brand is because we want people to hire us for the services we can offer, for the values that we stand for, and then we can make money out of our brands. Now, when I talk about branding, it's very different from what many people say. There are some girls who say, fake it until you make it. Now, that is not personal branding, because in personal branding, when you are out there, you should be the same person as you are in the home. Because if you're different, and eventually people get to know that you are different in public and different in private, then your brand is going to fail. There's actually no brand. You are just faking it. Now, personal branding, you bring out your values, your potential, and you front them out there. Let's talk about an experience. I one time know of an excellent person who would go to the offices, and she wants to work in humility. She never shares her achievements. She never reinforces her values. She just actually never talks about herself. And she's like, oh, people will notice what I do. My works will speak for me. And guess what? Her works never spoke for her. Every time there was a possibility of promotion, it's always the bad guys, the ones who talk, the one who fronts their little achievement and rub it in the face of everyone, who are known to everyone, that will be earning the job. Now, branding, you brand yourself consistently. You bring out your values. You talk about your values until everyone knows you as you have chosen to brand yourself. Now, there are people who brand themselves as smart thinkers. So when people are looking for smart thinkers, not that they are the best, but when people are looking for smart thinkers, they will come for them because that is the brand they have created. Call them at any time. They will be thinking, they will have solutions, they will have questions for the companies, and before you know it, everyone is coming to them. And the more you practice your brand, the more you get better. Okay, now we have talked about the potential, which potentials don't help. People will know you differently. They will probably think you are lazy. They will probably think you don't care, when actually you are not bothering to brand yourself. If you brand yourself so effectively, and your brand is quite unique, for instance, if you're making cakes, is it the normal cakes that everybody makes? Or you can choose to make cakes for children and people know that you're very good at that. Or you can choose to make ball cakes. You can choose to make vegetable cakes. You can choose to make vehicle cakes. And whatever you make that is so different is what is going to be your brand. And that is what people, the uniqueness of your values, the uniqueness of your service is what people will be looking for. And they will be coming for you because you have branded yourself faithfully. Now, branding has something to do with you bringing out your super powers, the hidden powers inside of you, and putting them out there in the public. Creating a personal branding statement. For instance, if you want success, come to me. Okay? Working with excellence can be your personal statement. The people who bring your work on time, that can be your personal statement. Working with effectiveness, that can be your personal branding. Now, as you bring out your brand, creating that person that you are, that speaks about you, that you want the public to buy and to be known by that, and that brand to make for you money, there has to be a statement. How do you throw that statement and your personal brand in the face of everyone so that you make money out of it? One, you must have a website. A website is where you draw traffic to. You must have a website. You must front everything about you on multiple online networks. Okay? Float your brand across multiple online platforms. You must choose like two or three platforms. Don't throw yourself everywhere and then eventually you fail to be noticed. Your brand fails to sell. If you are in Instagram, you are on TikTok, then create a website. If you are on Facebook or you are on YouTube, that work on it with a lot of consciousness, with a lot of consistency, and make sure that whoever comes to Facebook and they are getting the same message about you. Now, remember, we brand because we want people to buy our services. We want people to give us work, to give us jigs so that we can be able to earn money. So to brand effectively, be across social media platforms and have a website where you can draw traffic to. Create a networking and build links with the people who matter. Now, when you practice networking, you know, you will be increasing your chances of being known and places of selling your brand into. Networks, if you are in Rotary Club, you can be in a cell group, you can be in executive groups, you can be in a village group, you can be different groups on WhatsApp, you can be so many groups on Facebook. Make sure that you create a powerful network, because that powerful network is what is going to create the potential for your business. That is what is creating a potential for business. Now, the more you drum your brand, the more you live your brand, the more you sell your brand, the more people will find you. Remember, creating a personal brand at the end of the day is selling a product or earning a consultancy or earning income through who you are. Now, there are people who brand themselves as brand influencers. People want to sell their clothes. How do you dress? If you want to sell clothes for people, it means you're going to be minding so much about the clothes you wear, how you wear them, and how you look. If you want to sell phones, the phone you hold will speak so much about you. If you want to sell food, the food you eat, the presentation you make, what you talk about the foods is going to be your selling point. So, one, be across social media platforms. And two, be exactly what you are selling, both in public and in private. Be very consistent in this brand that you're creating. And eventually, you will find that you are exactly that what people think and what people, and what you present is what people will perceive of you. Many people present themselves as lazy, okay? They can't do anything. They wake up. They show you they're at the beach. They show you they are so helpless. They cannot do anything in this life. Will people wake up to give them anything? No. We are living in a world where brands are very important, where we have shifted from doing work only in the offices, that people will even hire us to do work in the home. What is your brand talking about you? Are you good in private? Are you selling out your brand? Are you consistent about the brand that you're selling? Are you creating a powerful network? Do you have a statement? Is there a website that you're drawing traffic so that when people need you, they can find you? I will urge you, express your brand so uniquely that when your clients are looking for you, you are not among the poor. They will be looking for you as you because your brand is very unique. Kindly create a brand. We are living in a very competitive world. Let your brand stand up. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please make a like, make a comment, and share this video if you have found it helpful. And go into the channel and enjoy so many other videos. Bye-bye for now. Thank you so much. God bless you.